The Pediatric Brain Tumor Foundation is the biggest nonprofit in the country that helps out kids and their families while they battle their illnesses. They do this in several ways, and Suzette Grindstaff, their campaign manager, joins me this morning to talk about the difference they make and how you can get involved. Good morning, Suzette. Welcome to Maryland Perspectives.
Good morning, Amelia. Thank you for having me.
Now, explain to us what a diagnosis of a brain tumor looks like in a child.
There are over 100 different kinds of brain tumors diagnosed in children, and those brain tumors can be located in any part of the brain. Some of the symptoms children experience at diagnosis can include persistent recurrent headaches, balance or walking problems, persistent or recurrent vomiting, blurred or double vision, behavior changes, seizures, and a tilt head or stiff neck. In order to confirm a brain tumor, a child needs to have an MRI or CT scan.
And those can get pretty expensive. It must be emotionally draining on the entire family when this diagnosis happens. How does the foundation help with this?
Well, we have a helpline that families can call, or they can email us to receive help and resource referrals. That is 800-253-6530 at extension 306, or family support at curethekids.org. And I'm also happy to announce a brand new program, Amelia. We're going to be launching our peer-to-peer mentor program this fall. This is a brand new program. It matches family members in need with other trained volunteer family members. Meeting someone who has walked through similar diagnosis can be very meaningful for families. And we also have help for children, too. There's videos online with our partner at ImaginaryFriendSociety.com. These videos help explain what's happening to the patient and to their siblings in a way that's on their level if they're young. We also conduct many events for families in the regions across the country, such as Starry Night Walks and Ride for Kid Motorcycle charity event programs. You see, Amelia, getting together in person gives families the opportunity to meet others just like them.
You're right. And a lot of the different nonprofits that I talk to, they talk about that peer-to-peer. They talk about families talking to other families that are going through the exact same things. And not only does it help them navigate different medical things that they have to deal with, but also the emotional toll that it takes. It's pretty amazing just talking to that one person. I know how it works for me in my life, and it's not even as drastic as, say, being diagnosed with a brain tumor. Your website is really fantastic too, Suzette. It helps families navigate the medical system, and each child's diagnosis is different. So how do you tailor your services to individual families?
Well, within the information we provide to families and our resources, like the Star Folio Notebook, we cover information about different types of tumors, different types of treatment, and the side effects of those treatments. We provide information for every stage of the newly diagnosed journey. We also have educational notebooks that you'll find on our website that help families know what questions to ask when their child is newly diagnosed.
That must just be a lifesaver for so many. And you also have what you call a toolkit that you provide families. So is that part of the toolkit?
Yes. The toolkit is actually called our Star Folio, and it's a research notebook for newly diagnosed families and contains information about childhood brain tumors and how to navigate the journey at each stage. The notebook features forms and templates to help families keep track of their child's medical records, communicate with their healthcare team, and communicate with the school. All the information is contained in a zip-up binder so that families can take the notebooks back and forth to the hospital and have their records all in one place.
And on the flip side of all of this, you're going through all of these treatments, you know, you've got your notebook, you're keeping track of everything. But then you're, you know, a couple months later, you're getting those medical bills in the mail, and the costs of this must just be outrageous. How do you help families navigate the costs of fighting the brain tumor?
Well, we have our emergency assistance program called the Butterfly Fund, and that provides financial assistance to families of children in treatment at partnering medical facilities. Families receive assistance with out-of-pocket expenses such as housing, transportation, and groceries, professional counseling, long-term rehabilitation, and other services that are often not covered by insurance. These financial hardships, like you say, pose serious barriers to patient care and can have devastating effects on all family members.
And now with the new technologies and better medicines that we're seeing in cancers, more and more kids are surviving these brain tumors, which is fantastic. So tell us how the foundation helps with funding research that has led to these breakthroughs.
Well, immunotherapy brings new hope to cancer treatment, and PBTF's two-part initiative will help level the playing field for children with brain tumors. And the PLGA Fund at PBTF fuels the most promising pediatric low-grade glaucoma and astrocytoma research. In addition, PBTF offers opportunity grants and early career development grants. Opportunity grants fill critical needs in pediatric brain tumor research, as recognized by our research advisory network, and multi-year early development grants support rising stars in research, feeding the field for future pediatric brain tumor discovery.
Now, this takes a lot of money. Not only are you helping out the families, but you're doing the research funding, and you're also leading the way when it comes to giving scholarships to these kids that are surviving the brain tumors. You mentioned some of the fundraisers earlier in the interview. Tell us about the one that's coming up on October 13th, Cure for the Kids Ride.
The Baltimore-Washington Ride for Kids event benefits the Pediatric Brain Tumor Foundation, and it's in its 28th year. What we raise goes towards the research and family support that we've been talking about. We are on the front line. We are fueling the research and family support with our fundraising and donations. It also serves as a family support program itself. The families are able to get together and experience a fun time with others like them in a non-stressful environment. And the kids, survivors, and families all get to ride in the ride with the motorcyclists. It's very therapeutic for a lot of our brain tumor patients and survivors, whom we lovingly call our stars. Some of them look forward to it all year long.
I bet.
As much or as more as Christmas time.
So where is it going to be?
It is going to be at Turf Valley Resort on October 13th, and that's in Ellicott City.
So do people have to register up front, or can they register right there on the grounds?
We offer both online registration as well as walk-up registration. They can go to our website at rideforkids.org/BALTWASH. That's rideforkids.org/BALTWASH and register online, or they can come at the event and register there at the event.
I've done a lot of different motorcycle rides, and to know that some of these kids and their families are going to actually be on the ride as well, that's really exciting. So if people can't do the ride, they can still donate or volunteer. And where can folks go to get more information about the foundation and maybe even donate?
They can donate directly onto our rideforkids.org site.
Okay.
Or they can go to find out more about the foundation at curethekids.org. Or by calling our toll-free number at 800-253-6530. And they can always call me directly for any questions about our event at 828-925-7099.
Suzette Grindstaff is the campaign manager for the Pediatric Brain Tumor Foundation. Suzette, I'll make sure I get all of those links and phone numbers up on our website, 98online.com. Thank you so much for being there for children and their families while they fight for their lives.
Thank you for having me, Amelia.